the teacher who is teaching in the regular school will be supported by a special educator and a psychologist. The school should have a special educator and a psychologist. The reporting has to be almost done every day. Now the child shows some behavioral issues that has to be handled by a team. A regular teacher may not be able to handle because she'll have a lot of pressure of, you know, completion of syllabus and correction and setting of question papers and so many other things where you do the records and other things. Now here the special educator or a psychologist will be able to help. Now I'll quote a small little example where a child had the palsiness on his right hand where he could not use that, and had little issue in walking. Of course slightly it had affected 20%, it had affected the leg of a right leg. So now what has happened with this child? The child he was quiet, but slowly he started, you know, showing lot of irritation, you know, he used to hit the children when he came to class 3. Now the child was quiet where he could actually manage the academics also. Probably when he came to class 3, probably the writing had become more, the you know, assessment, more activities, so many things. Now what has happened, the teacher could not handle the class. He used to hit others, he used to throw things and all. Now when it was discussed in a team, so I again insist it has to be a teamwork. When it was discussed in a team, the teacher was told by the coordinator and the head of the school, everybody, in your class, if he shows, just quickly change the activity, do another activity where you can take them out, or do change the activity. So for that particular teacher, for that class of class 3, we did not pressurize why you didn't complete the syllabus. That kind of a flexibility a head can give, where that particular class. Now this comes with the other parents. Other parents will say, why this section, the particular lesson is not being completed. This child, with the parents' you know, acceptance, has been taken out for some other activity, that too with the permission. The syllabus was completed for the other class. The child was taken it out from the class. Now this taking it out from the class should be done only with the parent concern. Otherwise the parents will say, oh, you're withdrawing my child every time from the class. The child is, you know, feeling uncomfortable to go inside the classroom in that particular subject. So one thing I would like to quote here, I don't have the solution, you don't have the solution, everybody has solution. Discuss, talk to everybody. No one particular solution will give. Probably the examples which I had given had worked with that particular child. It may work, it may not work with the other child. So every mother is a teacher, and every teacher is very creative. I love teachers. They are very creative. They are very observant. They are counselors. They can easily, this is not for, as a motivational statement I am giving. Definitely a teacher can actually identify with a small little, you know, behavioral change with the belt wearing, even the child, how the, you know, shirt is worn that particular day. You know, definitely the teachers can do, but a teacher alone will not be able to do. If it is a private school, the school management should support, the head should support. If there are coordinators, they should support, and all activity teachers should be involved in this, where they also bring in a lot of innovativeness in this. We know everything, probably we know the subject, we know how to handle the children, we know how the different techniques and of teaching, how to incorporate technology to bring in. Now the trainings will help. I would like to bring in the technology point also here, where the technology can actually help, wherein we recorded the few lessons for the children and we gave it to the parents, where parents said we could not help. About the maths lesson which I was talking about, a child, muscular dystrophy child, we recorded the teacher when she was teaching, and we gave it to them so that they can, you know, keep playing it while the child is eating or maybe fed. That is number one. Number two, I feel the humanity will never die, because I see now with the lockdown also, I can see a lot of people who talk about the animals. You know, a lot of groups are created, they go out of their way to help. And similarly, the special children, everybody, technology is helping everyone in every aspect. Now people are talking about even special needs. We had one of the a meeting with other people, I mean persons who are working in the special education, how we use this particular, you know, technology to, you know, reach those children, because they were not looking into the system this lockdown period. So we were trying to bring in, you know, we were trying to keep some food on top of the phone, that kind of a thing. So definitely training will help. Any teacher need not be very sympathetic. And this I would like to give one more. With the training, one has to give a lot of questionnaire to the self-assessment, where any teacher, anybody, including me, if you ask the question, you see a child could not walk, whether you will help, you give, you know, number one, where you rate yourself, number one to number 10, definitely I will place 10 and every teacher will do it. So questionnaire, where the self-assessment, where you keep giving them a child who is, you know, having a behavioral issue, will you send the child out or would you like to do a different kind of an activity settle? Everybody will place that. So, you know, it's kind of an understanding of yourself where you don't want to portray yourself bad, you know, wherever you are in writing, when you are doing self-assessment, any even psychological test, if it is available in online, when you do, definitely you give your best, you give the most numbers. So training and self-assessment of a teacher, definitely the humanity is always existing. So this will definitely come out. They will definitely portray. And you go to any workshop, anywhere, initially people who are apprehensive about how do we, you know, integrate or, you know, include the special children. It's very difficult, you know, maybe they are drooling, they are not being able to walk properly, they don't talk, they have behavioral issues. At the end of the day, everybody will say, I think I can try, I will do it. So definitely the technology also definitely will help. Now we are helping the children to look into the system where the few children they don't look into, where when it comes to, again, I'm bringing the autism children where they are not been, but slowly they will also get into, you know, looking into the system. But otherwise for the intellectual disability children, we give the audio lessons and video lessons. Some children, they don't. So audio lessons, we keep playing. It is kind of a conditioning where you keep listening to the particular word, where how you learn the pronunciation of a foreign language when you learn. You keep listening to that particular word, the pronunciation automatically gets. So definitely this kind of recording will come again with one of the child for expression. We used to use the card where the child has to pick up a card. I have to go to the washroom. So there was a software person who had come when I was in Delhi. So they created a small tab in that switches were there. You know, where the through the switch the child used to communicate. So definitely with the technology, but with the distance teaching learning, it is still difficult. One or two are able to look into it and learn. It is slightly difficult, but kind of an activity. Again, we keep troubling the parents. Please make them do this kind of activity during this lockdown period.